I had a dream when I was pregnant with you that a man cut you out of my belly with an electric knife.
Huh?
You know, like the one you use on Thanksgiving. And he just pulled you at me.
This is a story about my best friend. Helvetica Bird. She's 8 years old. This is the day her mother died. Here she is today, the day her husband leaves her for a religious cult. And this day she will die. It was straight out of a movie screen. Woody Allen asking Diane Keaton to start their date off with a kiss. Sentiment and cynicism butted out for a quick 3 rounds inside Helvetica's brain. Sentiment won on points.
Okay, I'll go first. I really like the Microsoft Office paperclip guy.
I've always found them relaxing. They're so clean and organized. Plus, I love the schedule. I've got 2 hours to kill, all alone. I can totally read the chunk of my book before I go.
No,
we can talk about that later. Be more offensive.
I don't like Bob Dylan.
What?
He can't sing.
He doesn't have to sing.
Yeah, he should.
I don't believe in God.
Well, I'm Jewish, but I'm anti-Zionist.
I'm not that interested in the news. I just don't care.
It's hard to care. I like Ben Affleck.
I like country music.
Well, I like death metal.
I didn't vote last time.
I haven't voted in years.
What's the point?
I can't fucking stand to look at myself in the mirror.
Who can?
I
think we all feel that way sometimes.
Is that it?
That's it.
That's stupid.
I bet I can catch a fish.
How is it stupid?
It just is.
It's about how what you have is better than some uncertain thing you may have in the future.
I get it, Dad. I'm just saying. Okay. My turn.
Go ahead.
The fisherwoman narrowed her eyes.
A talking fish? She shouted,
and struck a deal with the little fish on the spot. I will never let harm come to you, little fish, she said, if you will agree to jump into this bowl here and tour the country and go on television and make us both rich. Said the little fish.
The stream is pretty boring.
We'll see the world together, said the wonderfully bright and beautiful fisherwoman. 50-50. The little fish narrowed his eyes.
60-40.
Well, there might be some other ones that are a bit easier for beginners. I think I like him. He looks, well, not like a Myron. Like a Joe Harris.
You're a Darcy Rearman.
You could say that.
Oh my God, you're...
I'm surprised you recognized me.
I'm reading it to my son. He loves you.
Oh, kids don't know books by the authors, just the stories. He loves Darkly. He's probably not even aware I exist yet.
What is this one?
Oh, yeah. Just a good name. The necklace in her mouth.
What?
I don't know who told me that would
be up. Yeah, she's a great writer. I just don't think she cares about the business side of it.
Oh.
She just lets other people make decisions for her, and now she gets ridiculed at parties by her peers.
Hey.
You see what you did there?
It was so.
Thank you.
This a nice picture, really. Just me in the house, where I'd rather be right now.
Well, you want to go home? We can go home. Fuck these people.
Yeah. What is this anyway?
The American Library Association.
Oh, why
about creativity?
She's been not working on it now for weeks.
Something will come.
Okay, now you're making me nervous.
I'll just make it up when I get up there. It's not that big a deal. I should have been a pair of rugged claws scuttling across the side of the sea.
Oh yeah, that's popular. Super peppy.
Oh, that's my cue to get more drinks.
I'm sorry,
I don't want to go away. No. You know, you'll listen to him. You're not who he thinks you are. You do need something. You do. No. Stop. Please. Listen to me. Please. Please. I know you can hear me. Don't do this. I don't like it up here. I'm scared. I'm all alone.
Once upon a time, there was a ballerina.
And she was perfect. She was beautiful and eternally young, and she danced all day and never got tired. Yes, she was perfect in all the ways you can be perfect.
Except the most important way. She wasn't real. Instead of blood and bones and flesh and fingernails, she was made of wood and some clockwork parts. And when a small crank was turned, she danced to a number of different songs.
She lived in a music box in the toy maker's window, and little girls and boys loved to watch her dance, and their laughter made her happy.
And one day she was sold to a rich man who lived in the heart of the palace, an advisor to the queen, they said.
The ballerina was very excited to dance for the palace. And when the advisor's wife opened the gate, she clapped her hands and laughed, and the ballerina danced and danced.
And the years passed. She didn't dance as much as she did when she was living in the toy maker's window.
But she didn't mind. She appreciated the times that she could still dance.
But when you do one thing, any time not spent doing it is torture.
Glad to be back.
Hoist the sail, stupid bear.
Aye, Captain!
Da-da-da-da!
Always.